Now we continue on.
Well, now, students aren't allowed in here, are they? There are things in the forbidden corridor that are not for the eyes of mere boys like you.
Fine.
No, indeed. Dumbledore has ordered that no students are to enter this corridor. And don't go trying a secret passage. Mrs. Norris and I know them all. Now be off with you, before I have you expelled for wasting our time.
Okay, bye-bye. I don't really want to watch that scene again, so I'm going to save again. There. Now we will continue on. Wait for him to continue on his merry way. There. Let's see, there's a... Okay, I think I see the key. Go on, jump, Harry. Oh dear God. Jump. I messed up. Just wait for... Yeah, you don't have to worry about them. They never look up. Grab this. And I'm magically invisible again. Go on. Up. Jump. Grab the key. No! Grab the stupid freaking key! Oh my God, I am failing so bad at this right now. I don't know why. Books. Bookshelf. Bookshelf! Jump. Grab the key, finally. Unlock the door. Finally, my God. No save. That sucks. All right. You can stay back here as long as you need to. He never comes back this way.
Yes, Mr. Filch. What is it? Professor Snape, you said to alert you if I heard anyone sneaking around in the forbidden corridor. Well, Mrs. Norris and I suspect that one of the students may be trying to sneak past us.
I see. That's very interesting, Mr. Filch. And I have an idea who it might be. But we have ways of dealing with interlopers. You have my permission to use the harshest measures necessary. There is something very special in the forbidden corridor that I've had my eye on for some time. We can't let anyone interfere with my plans. Can we, Mr. Filch?
No, indeed, Professor Snape. Mrs. Norris and I will be extra vigilant watching out for intruders.
See that you do, Mr. Filch. I have something special planned for anyone who tries to defy me.
That's nice. Can I go through here? Fine. I'm kind of confused. I thought I would be able to go through this way. Oh, there we go. Now, this is the part that sucks. Really bad. I hate that cat. Let's see. I don't remember exactly how to do this part very well. Can't tell if that's one beam or two. I think it's only one. Wait for that cat to... Go on, kitty. Yeah, no one likes you, kitty. Grab the key. I don't want to have to do this again. Through the door. Yay! Anything around here? Bye-bye. Don't remember where the key is, though. I want to... Let's see, there's the door. The key has to be somewhere on the... Oh, I want that. There we go. I'm not even gonna try to get through the door that Mr. Filch is at. Oh, dear God. No, go, 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 go! Go, go. Thank God. See if I can line this up right. There we go. And through the door. Not very hard. Oh, again? I thought that was the last one. Fine. I'm jumping up here first. That cat. I hate that cat. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Thank God. He'll see you, but he doesn't see you unlocking the door. If he'll see you if the invisibility cloak wears off, but even if you're invisible, you can unlock the door right in front of him and he never sees. So, don't worry about that. Yay! That was it! Thank God. I'll let you guys enjoy this cute little scene.
Reflected in the mirror of Erised were Harry's parents, James and Lily Potter. Harry stared hungrily back as though hoping to fall right through the glass and reach them. He was startled when a voice sounded behind him. Harry turned slowly about. So you, like hundreds before you, have discovered the delights of the Mirror of Erised, said Professor Dumbledore. He went on to explain that the mirror showed nothing more or nothing less than the deepest, most desperate desire of our hearts, but that it would give neither knowledge nor truth. The Mirror of Erised will be moved to a new home shortly, Dumbledore went on, adding ominously that if Harry ever came across it again, he would be prepared. But prepared for what? Thought Harry.